Hi folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on deleting MinIO objects with our Python client API. And in this video, we're going to be using Python 3.9 as well as play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And last but not least, we're going to be showing you all of this out of Visual Studio Code. To dig in a little bit on what we're going to see in this video and what you'll be able to work with when the video is over is this remove object method. And the remove object method can also remove a specific version. At the basic level, it requires you to give it a bucket name and the object you want it to delete. So it's a fairly simple method to actually use. Let's dig into some code. And as promised, this is a fairly simple piece of code to use. Here I've imported MinIO and also my MinIO demo functions. I'm using that to connect to our play.min.io there on line 5. And then I'm going to be deleting from the Python demo bucket the backup image.png. Very simple call, client, remove object, bname, oname, and you're done. Let me show you what we've got out there right now. If I do an mcls-r to get recursive on play with our Python demo bucket, as you can see, we've got that backup image out there already for us. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and run this code, Python 3, demo.py. No response, no return, anything like that, because really when you're removing an object, that's all you're going to get. If I do that mcls one more time, now you can see that the backup image is gone. If I run the same code a second time, no errors. If you try to remove something that's already gone, it's not going to be a problem. It's simply gone. So let me go ahead and show you what this would look like if we're going to work with versions. If I do an mcls with versions, and I do this against play Python demo bucket. As you can see, we've got a lot of versions out there. We've got all these put images that we've got there. We also have this rather odd version 4 of our hello world that kind of sticks out like a sore thumb in the middle of all these other 12 bytes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy that version number, that exact version number. I'm going to add that to my method call. Put a little quote around it. And I'm also going to change the actual object that I'm trying to delete. In this case, it's going to be hello world.txt. That's what we're actually trying to delete, that object and that version of that object. So let me go ahead and save that. I'm going to come back down here. I'm going to run this one more time, Python 3 demo.py. It runs very cleanly. If I then go and I run that mcls with versions one more time, what do I get if I scroll back up to my hello world section? Well, guess what? Now that version is gone. I have a different version 4 because it just counts the number of versions I have out there. But that one that was sticking out like a sore thumb is now gone. I've removed that rogue version. Of course, later on, I did go to the 1.5k version of that hello world text. And there's also that 11 byte version still sort of sitting out there at version 7. But that's how you can delete objects, including a specific version of a specific object out on min.io. I hope you enjoyed this little demo on how to remove objects. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can connect with us with any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.